Welcome back to Wasteland 2. So, Woodson said that there's somebody who wants to meet me back at Santa Fe Springs. So let's go check that out. I'm trying to think of who it could be. Didn't he say that the person who wanted to meet me... The person who wanted to meet me knows me? Who would know me and be out here? Other than the provost, but I already just met him, so... Who are you people? Pistol Pete. There's Woodson. Hi. Rangers, this is Fred Peterson, otherwise known as Pistol Pete. He's a traveling gun and armor salesman from a town to the west of us called Rodia. And he could use our help. Maybe this person doesn't know me, because I definitely don't know Pistol Pete. But anyway, I think my weapons are woefully out of date for this region, so I could certainly use some upgrades. You look exactly like Woodson. Like the man said, my name's Fred. But ain't nobody call me that. All over L.A., they know me as Pistol Pete. The straight-shootinest, straight-talkinest gun seller north of the 95. If you want to buy or sell, I'm ready to deal. But if you've a mind to help a fella in need, I'd appreciate you hearing me out. Sure, how can we help you, Fred? Pete? Well now, here it is. I trade all over, but my wife and I live in Rodia. And right now, damn it, a bunch of pug uglies took over the town and they're shaking down everybody who goes in or out. If I was to go back, they'd take all of my stock and probably kill me to boot. Now, a damn fine shot for a man my age, but I'm only one man, and it would take a posse of well-armed folks, such as yourselves, to pry those jackanapes loose of poor old Rodia. So, what do you say? I sort of came upon you folks by accident, but if you want to do like Lieutenant Woodson says you do, and establish yourselves as the good guys around here. I can't think of a better way to show your good intentions than chasing off those no-necks and showing them who's boss. And it would sure be nice to see my wife again. Of course. Well, ain't that fine. Now I could put Rodia on your map for you, or if you could use somebody along who knows the lay of the land, I'd be happy to show you the way. Like I said, I got a good eye and a steady hand if things get dicey. I think I'm fine. You can just stay here. So how'd you stumble across us? I heard some shooting, and I figured it was some kind of battle going on. I came down to see if there was any bits and pieces I could scavenge, but lo and behold, I find your Lieutenant Woodson here instead, laying out the welcome mat. I thought he already marked it on the map. Maybe he didn't? Let's see. Thank you. So, who are these pug uglies? They call themselves the Leather Jerks, and I gotta hand it to them. The name fits. Run by a little fella with big ideas, all of them bad. They say they're protecting the town, but as far as I can see, they're just milking it dry. And ain't nobody got the guts to stop them. So tell me about Rodia, this little town that you live in. Used to be a nice little farm town. We provided a lot of food for the other communities hereabouts. The garden spot of L.A., we like to call it. And people used to come from miles around to look our towers, too. Beautiful things. Now these rascals have taken over. Nobody come around no more. Trade has dried up and these people are going hungry. Sickness among the farmers and I don't know what else. It's terrible. Actually, sounds like it might not be a small town. Sounds like it might be quite large. Oh, right, towers! I could use towers. What kind of towers are these? Radio towers? Huh. Well, no. Not originally, at least. You ain't never heard of our towers? Why, they're famous! Art from before the end of the world. Our mayor had them made into radio towers a while back, but the Leather Jerks smashed the transmitter as soon as they moved in. Now they're just pieces of art again. Well, I'll turn them back into transmitters. Alright, let's see what you got. Ooh, Kevlar. Nice, so that's an upgrade from what everybody's wearing right now, which is, what the hell are they wearing? Well, whatever we're wearing, it's the, it's four armor, so that's, oh yeah, tactical vest. Sweet. To grab one of those, and you only have pistols? That's it? Lame. Nobody even has handgun skill except for, Helen. She only has, like, one point in it. God, look at that thing. 34 to 50 damage. That's impressive. Not much armor penetration, though. Welp, I think that's gonna do it for me. Do I have any more scrap to sell? I just sold my stuff, right? Pretty much. Couple hands. Yeah, I'm not gonna sell my stuff. Take that, thank you very much. Okay, who do I give this to? Definitely not my snipers, because they rarely get hit. Who is in the most danger? I suppose it's Lexcanium, but he sucks and I'd rather just make him hide, so fuck him. Bazeppi's got more health than other people. Maybe Yulia, because she's a shotgunner? Yeah, let's give it to Yulia. Now, I think there's somebody actually missing armor, right? Let's see. Yeah, it's Lexcanium. Alright, so let's give Lexcanium Yulia's hand-me-down. And, oh, he doesn't even have a trinket. Doesn't really matter. Do I have any trinkets that are just purely buffs, no negatives? I think I do. Yeah, unusual bow, there's one. Oh, plus to crit chance. There's another one. Oh, wow, I just realized the blank voodoo doll is simply not as good as the unusual bow. 2% as opposed to 3%. The only good thing about it is the fact that it weighs less. Anyway, there you go. Why are you overweight? What do you have that weighs so much? That's a lot of sniper ammo, jeez. I guess we could break this down. Sure. That thing's 10 pounds, that doesn't help. I think it's all this freaking pistol ammo. She really does have a lot of pistol ammo. Oh yeah, and these like bits of plating are also really heavy. Well, I guess I'll just sell them off. And let's just sell the majority of this ammo. I feel like she's strangely overweight. 77 pounds. Oh, it's because the anti-material rifle weighs 26. Ah. That'll do it. Okay, let's give this to Vulture's Cry. Because I'll put that there as her secondary. What kind of ammo does it use again? 762. Find more 762? I think I did. Yeah, it's actually got a ton of that. Sweet. Okay. Looks like we got a couple other sellers. Let's see if you got some nice stuff as well.
LAPD! Get on the ground!
I love that dude's portrait, that's awesome. Welcome to Taco Clown, may I take your order? Sure. Whoa! Whoa, this dude's rich too. Holy crap.
Oh, beautiful. Saw sword. What is that? Things. Lots of things. Another Kevlar vest.
Kevlar suit. Okay, well, I'm gonna take a look at these and I'll be right back. Okay, so I went ahead and bought a bunch of weapons. Let's take a look at what I got. First I should probably put the Kevlar vest on. Who do I want to give that to? So I already gave one to Yulia. Let's give the other one to Harper. Sure. Then I guess I can just sell this thing. Worth a decent amount of money. Okay, so first thing I bought was an AK... I wanted to call it an AK-47, but it's an AK-97.
Future technology.
You know, hold on, I just realized right now that this actually uses a different kind of ammo than the M16. Hmm. I guess I'm gonna have to buy some ammo. But anyway, as you can see, the stats are significantly better. 45 to 66 damage instead of 37 to 48. Pretty good increase. Aside from that, everything else is pretty much the same, except for the damage and the armor penetration. So capacity and range and all that is pretty comparable. The main difference is just the damage, and it has two more armor penetration, which is very significant, especially since I'm going up against a lot of robots. So pretty important. I've already put some upgrades on it, so that's why the range is so much higher than the M16. Well, actually, that's one of the reasons the range is so much higher. It's actually only got a plus 3 meters, so the base range is actually 35. Which is actually way, way, way more than the M16. That's 11 meters more than the M16. Yeah, that is awesome. So, let's go ahead and use that. Gonna have to get some ammo for it. This 5.56 ammo is gonna go to waste. What a shame. Okay. Aside from that, we also have... Oh yes, the shotgun. Let's go move that over there. I was installing some mods on all the guns with Helen. Okay, so here's the tactical shotgun as compared to the over-under. So I bought the tactical shotgun. As you can see, the damage is significantly higher. Much higher capacity. The cone angle is a little bit lower. And the armor penetration is a little bit higher. So it's actually not amazing. It's not hugely better than the over-under. But it does do a bit more damage and it has a little bit more armor penetration. And one of the things I really like about it is the fact that it costs 4 AP for a single shot. And not, say, 5 AP or anything like that. Because I was a little bit worried about it at first and the fact that it didn't have a burst shot. But the fact is, I can basically make my own burst shot by simply shooting twice. Which is effectively the same as the burst shot in the over-under, because with the over-under I had to do a burst shot and then reload. In this case, I can just do two single shots, and I don't have to reload because the capacity is 7. So basically it's pretty similar to the over-under, except I have more control over what I shoot. I don't have to do a burst shot, I can just do a single shot and then do another single shot somewhere else. So a little bit more control there. I like it. Definitely not a huge upgrade, though. Also have a new SMG here. So bought the MP5. Once again, significantly more damage. Let's see, anything else majorly different? The range is pretty similar, a little bit closer, actually. And yeah, so this one's similar to the shotgun. Where most stuff is pretty much the same, except it does just a little bit more damage and has a little bit more armor penetration. So as you can see, the damage per AP is very, very similar. 14.4 damage per AP instead of 14. So very close, but it's a little bit better, and it also eats up less ammo. As you can see, the damage is actually slightly higher with the burst shot times 3 compared to the burst shot times 4 of the TMP9. So it's a little bit more efficient. And that's all I've got. I didn't want to buy any brawling gloves because the current, or arms, whatever you want to call them, because the current ones that Lexcanium has actually give them +2 to brawling. So if I got rid of those, he would suck at brawling. He'd be completely incompetent, even more than he already is. I wasn't too happy with the snipers. I also wasn't happy with the energy weapons, actually. They didn't seem worth it. And unfortunately, there was only one assault rifle that I wanted to buy, so that's why I only bought the one for Harper, instead of also replacing Theodore's. It's okay, somebody's gotta use up the rest of the 5.56 ammo anyway. So yeah, I need to buy ammo. So what does it use? 7.62? Who has 7.62? One of my snipers uses it. Yeah, there it is. That's for the... Wait, why do you have that? Oh, right, it's for the Argent, I guess? I thought someone else had it, too. I guess not. Alright, so 43 rounds of it. That's not bad. I guess I don't need to buy any more yet. We'll see if I find some more out in the world. So, should be fine for now, I suppose. Would you like to heal me? $20 scrap for a heal? Sure. Only healed one person? That's fine. 20 scrap is basically nothing. Should probably go ahead and sell my tactical vest here, since it's very, very heavy. I also want to do some mod installations. I want to see... Well, let's try to strip this thing for parts. Oh. Right, need to give it to Helen. High-capacity mag, nice. I don't think I'm going to be using the Argent anymore. It's kind of getting old, so let's strip that down. Strip down the Temp. And the Over-Under. Quick mag? Ooh, I don't know what that does. Let's check it out. Wait a minute. Hold on. You have things attached to you. Okay, quick mag, what does that do? Oh, it takes down the reload AP, as well as the chance to jam. Hmm. I don't think that really matters for most people, except maybe a shotgun, but can it even be used on a shotgun? No, it can't. Eh. I mean, I guess it's slightly better than a sturdy mag, because it's pretty much the same negative percent chance to jam, but it also adds on the -1 reload AP. So, that's kinda neat. But, I think I'm just gonna do the high-capacity mag. Then again, do I really need more than 30 rounds? I mean, it already holds 30. I don't think I do. I guess I'll just put the quick mag in it. Oh, it looks like it's automatically gonna recover the current sturdy mag. Cool. Nice. Who else? Let's see if there's anything we can do with a shotgun. Shotguns, unfortunately, can only take chokes. I don't have any choke for that yet. Let's see if there's anything more I can put in your sniper rifle. Barrel, under barrel. Do I have a flashlight? No. Should be able to do something for the MP5. Nah, it's already got a high-capacity mag. Underbarrel, barrel. Nope. Okay, how you doing, Woodson? 1 second, Rangers. Listen, this is a great opportunity for us, on several levels. One, if we can help these folks, we will build our reputation here in the LA area. Two, these towers he's talking about could be a good boost to our signal. Increasing the range of our message could be as easy as riding into the town and saving the day. So, what I'm saying is, don't fuck it up. Gotcha. Hmm, Alright, I was gonna go all the way back to the center place where that crate is that contains all of my loot. Because I have a bunch of modifications in there, like high-capacity mags and stuff, but I'm too lazy to run all the way over there. It's like a 20-second run. No thanks. I'm good. Okay, so where are we going? Suppose we should probably head to Rodia. Let's go. Dugan's worker bots. Maybe I can hack them? Nah, they're gonna be red right off the bat. Alright, so these are the melee dudes. Maybe if I wait until they're looking the other way, I can just run away from them. Let's see, so that guy's looking away. Huh? I want to see if this works. This game doesn't really have any sort of a stealth system. No, oh, he caught me. All right, let's test the AK-97 out. I'm surrounded. Shit. Or, not surrounded, but under pressure. Alright, that's not gonna work. Let's move away and just take one shot at him. 76? Wow. Not bad. Alright, let's test out this tactical shotgun. That is not a good place to test it out. Unless I can angle it just right to just hit him. That should be impossible. And it is. There we go. I can just do it. Why am I shooting him with a shotgun? It just occurred to me that I should be using my energy weapon. I guess I was just excited to try it out. Alright, give him a good punch, and then run away. Ooh, let's test out the anti-material rifle. I just moved too far accidentally. Let's not test out the anti-material rifle. Five armor penetration. These things have seven armor. Nah. Let's use the Mason cannon. Let's try this thing out for the fun of it. It's got a little bit more penetration. Six instead of five. Damage? Oh my god, I rolled like the lowest it could possibly roll. That's the weird thing about that weapon, it has a huge damage variance from like 10 to 90 or something. That's a terrible chance to hit. You know, I do want to know what this 100% chance to apply all tied up thing is. Let's try it. Okay, a worker bot is tied up. I don't know what that means. Maybe that means it can't move for the next turn? Alright, let's test out the anti-material rifle. 10 armor penetration. Let's even do a headshot. Whew! 270 damage. Yeah, I'm gonna save that gun for the hard stuff. I'm not gonna use it on these little piddly things, even if they do have high armor. I'm gonna save that for, like, super big things. What in the hell are you wearing? What is going on here? There's a bunch of dead robots everywhere. Samuel? Sure, what have you got? Ooh, another Kevlar vest. I'll take that, thank you. I think all this other stuff is stuff I've already saw the other guy. Suppressor. Ooh. Eliza Rock. Plus one to perception. Eh. Now that is an AK-47. That's a really low tier weapon. It's funny, the AK-97 is better than the AK-47. Is the model number just gonna keep going up? Is it like video cards? Am I gonna find like an AK-100, an AK-120, an AK-125 Ti? Minus 90% noise radius modifier. I don't get it. This game doesn't really have a stealth system. I mean, okay, if everybody had suppressors on, or if you only had the one person who has a suppressor attack and nobody else shoots, then I guess you could maybe only attract, like, one enemy instead of a bunch? I guess. But stealth just doesn't really work in this game. It's almost non-existent. So it kind of feels awkward to even attempt that. It does increase your critical hit chance, though, by quite a bit. But, nah, I've got weaponsmithing for a reason. I'll find that part on a weapon at some point. No reason to buy it. Okay, who to replace next? Frontline soldiers. Pazeppi? Let's do Pazeppi. Sell my old vest here. Alright, what's going on? I never paid to get into Rodia before. Rules have changed, old man. Now that the Right Honorable Enormous what did that say? Right Honorable Enormous Obiggin? Six bullets per person. Oh, he's gonna die. Yep. Well, let's go see if we can talk some sense into this guy. More likely, though, is that we're gonna have to blow some sense into him. Hey. Well, you're not a guy, never mind. I'm still gonna have to probably kill you, though. A jerk of the female variety. She looks like sanity was something she traded away for a skinning knife. Stop right there, strangers. If you want to get into Rodia, jewel of the LA wetlands, and home of the world-famous Rodia Towers, you gotta donate to the Rodia Security Bullet Fund. 6 bullets per person. Give me the tour, tell me about your lovely town. This place was a real shithole till we brought our civilizing influence. Now it's a jewel. Uh-huh. You have towers? People come from miles around to see them towers. No idea why. They don't do anything. Even the old transmitter that turned them into radio towers don't work anymore. Good for hanging out the laundry, though. Ain't it, boys? Tell me about your radio. Done talking till you're done paying. Okay. Six bullets per person. I don't want to pay. If I pay, could I perhaps find out a clever way to unravel this whole thing later? If I don't pay, I'm probably gonna just... We're gonna have to kill each other right here. Most likely. What if there's a keyword here? What if I, like, offer to put the repeater on the towers? That did literally nothing. Literally does nothing. Okay, cool. Fine, I'll pay. Whatever. 42 bullets. Alright, give you the shittiest ammo possible. Here, just to make it awkward. There you go, 41, 38s, and 112 gauge. Thank you, citizen. We'll put those bullets to good use. And listen, you all look like you know how to handle yourselves. If you're looking for work, see our boss, Enormous O'Biggin, or Lieutenant Dangler, his second in command. O'Biggin? Really? Our boss lets his fists do the talking. He hits like a car wreck. You best stay on his good side. What about Dangler? He's little, but he's got a big brain. And that brain will fuck you up if you ain't careful. What kind of work? Gunslingers. Okay. Let's see if we can enact change from the inside. Gummy? Pokey? Oh, they have those hilariously weird mob names. Wait, what's going on? What are you doing? A leather jerk in orange leather stops before you. A handful of jerks behind him. He slaps his machete against his palm as he gives you the once-over. A jerk in green leather stands beside him, staring, open mouth. Opened mouth. He has no teeth. Slow your roll, strangers. Who the hell let a bunch of arm-to-the-teeth motherfuckers in here? Did Bullet Grabber let you in? What do you want? We paid her and she let us in. Stupid bitch. You still got bullets for those guns, you didn't pay her enough. Well, I ain't risking my leather trying to take that shit away from you. But if you start some shit, know that we do not run out of ammo. Understand me? That's right, losers. We got clips to spare. So how did your dumbass friend get the name Gummy? Is it named after the consistency of his brain? Have you seen him smile? See, I got no teeth. Good for you. Your name's Pokey? I like to poke things with my poker. Sometimes I poke them so hard they die. Okay, bye. They have the mayor in a cage. And he's hooked up to a thingy. Well, I could probably hack that and get him down, but actually getting in there without attracting attention from the tower guards would be a little bit difficult. I might just have to shoot him. I don't know, we'll have to see. I'm gonna get a lay of the land before I start letting the bullets fly. I wonder what the Provost... Why is he here? I don't get why he's here. How did he come back from the dead? It's creepy. Anyway, I think I better end this episode here. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.